They come in 25-8, and they are taking on the third-seeded Louisville Cardinals. The winner of this game will advance to take on sixth-seeded Oklahoma on Sunday in Birmingham. Oklahoma outlasted a valiant St. Joseph's comeback and won that game. Butler and Tennessee advanced earlier. Thomas, Boucher, Tiedemann, Larry, and Nelson for Boise State. And for the Cardinals, Smith, McGee, Terrence Williams, Juan Palacios getting the start tonight, and David Padgett. Those two seniors missed the first part of the season when this Louisville team got off to a very rough start, 7-3 in November and December. Tonight's game is being brought to you in HDTV by HP. The officiating crew, Gary Maxwell, Bill Kennedy, Mike Thibodeau. First meeting between these two teams since 1994 in the first round of the NCAA. That was a Louisville victory over Boise State in the first round game played in Sacramento.
Well, the ability to get it into the bigs is important for Louisville and to challenge the threes of Boise. And Boise's got a counter with good outside shooting. And right now, Boise State, Vern Lundquist goes. Wait a minute.
David Padgett steals the tip. He's got the ball in his hands now. Jumper, Terrence Williams.
Well, they shoot. They're a different team. That two-pointer, a deep one.
That was inside the line for Williams, so it's a 2-0 start. Here is Reggie Larry, too strong off the glass. Offensive board and a bad pass. I just get this. Louisville's been here so many times. You wonder about the enthusiasm, the excitement of this Boise State team taking on the Louisville Cardinals.
Well, it's got to impact them early, but they got to settle down, use the floor. They love the threes, and they run some nice stuff to get it, and they use the whole floor.
Williams off the dribble in the lane. Short, gets his own rebound. Nice. Padgett.
Turnover here. Two good passers on the floor in Williams and Padgett. Padgett trying to kick it out.
And so that will be Boise State ball. Tyler Tiedemann will inbound, number 20. Back to Tiedemann, who's a three-point specialist.
He can rifle it from deep, too.
Anthony Thomas, the only undergraduate, or rather non-senior. There are three graduates on this team. And here's in the lane. Misfire. Palacios gets the rebound.
Now Nelson trying to go to that left hand.
Williams.
What a start.
Pressure applied. Williams. Thomas gets it across the timeline. Reggie Larry and Padgett picks up the foul. Terrence Williams, terrific start.
Well, you want to do some good things, some positive things. It's the screen that gets them free for that clean stroke. And then that sets up their pressure. They're relentless. They deflect from the rear. They chart it. They're always raking at the dribbler. You've got to be strong with the basketball against Louisville.
Reggie Larry off a brilliant performance and a triple overtime win in Las Cruces, New Mexico, against New Mexico State for the WAC championship. He had 31 in that game.
And of course, first team all WAC. A little undersized in that box area, but he can play in and out. A little 2-3 look now. See if Louisville can make shots. They're going to test them. Once in a while, they come up empty.
Padgett has it.
And the best shooter is Smith on the floor.
McGee, not necessarily an offensive threat. Here's Tiedemann.
Off of him, too.
Yeah,
that's
off
that deflection.
His knee.
That's what they do. They rush you, harass you.
There's Rick Pitino in his seventh season as the head coach of the Louisville Cardinals. Padgett again. We've played 2 minutes. Terrence Williams has both buckets. Williams for three.
Well, he is going to the round, huh? What a start. He fills the stat sheet. Another good play by Palacios.
Terrence Williams has all of the Louisville points.
This kid had a triple-double this year. A little rainbow trajectory. But his game is driving in the lane and getting it to others and occasionally finishing.
had two triple-doubles, the third and fourth in the history of Louisville.
Samaki Walker.
Yes.
Ellis Miles, the others. There's that 2-3 zone, and they attack, Vern. They do not let you have a clean look. They challenge shots.
Look at McGee up in Tiedemann's face. And now he's over on Matt Bauscher. The foul is called on Jerry Smith.
Well, they know these outside guys can shoot.
Head coach Greg Graham in his sixth season as Boise State. A small footnote, his first head coaching job was in high school in his hometown, which is Louisville, Ohio. He said those folks in Kentucky have had it wrong all these years.
They say it wrong, huh? Yeah. Louisville. And he played for Dick Harder. How about that? Terrific coach at Penn and later on Oregon, Penn State, NBA, you name it. Still on the bench with the Pacers.
Nelson. Bauscher.
Nice slip
pass.
And a neck ball.
Hell ball, possession arrow goes to Boise State. Now the Broncos from Boise chartered down here. That's a rarity for them. 3.5 hour trip. And they come to Birmingham. As the tournament champions of the WAC.
Nice offensive rebound. They get Padgett.
Enrollment just under 20,000. This is their fifth NCAA appearance, first in 14 years. And they are still looking for their first tournament victory. They went to triple overtime to defeat New Mexico State in Las Cruces before a crowd of 10,000. Rick Pitino telling us he watched that game because his former assistant, Marvin Menzies, is the head coach at New Mexico State.
And they feel that would help them play in the same type of philosophy.
On the line.
Having a rough start here. And they just get FD defensively, Louisville. They make a chaotic attempt.
Padgett has picked up two fouls, and he gets a seat near Rick Pitino. Derek Characters come on for the Cardinals.
And he gives him some inside punch. He's powerful around the rim, holds off. It's good position for follows.
Smith. Williams. Loose ball.
Nice hustle.
Sure was. Here's Bauscher. Smith gets back. Bauscher, not there. Earl Clark with a rebound.
A talent on the floor, too. Earl can do some damage on the boards as well.
At the other end, Williams saves it, kicks it out. Three.
That's what they need from Smith. That is his game. Offensive rebound, kick and find.
Boise State 0-for-5, three turnovers. Thomas, finally.
A nice screen and really nobody close to help out. Even though they play zone, they get over there, occasionally trap that thing.
10-3, now McGee has it in his hands. Character and Clark, and Clark threw it away.
The ability to find is something Williams possesses. Nylon by Smith from Wauwatosa, Wisconsin. Charge Williams to do so many things. Here he's knocking jump shots down. They're not being challenged. He's getting clean looks. He gets 7 rebounds, Vernon, 4.5 assists a game. When he makes them like that and he's creative with the bounce, they are a very difficult team because of the relentless nature of their defense.
And Terrence Williams has led the way, this 10-3 lead with 15:31 to go. There's Tiedemann trying to get across the timeline.
Interesting, and they let Thomas play the post, and if he gets it, he can turn it into a fast break.
Thomas guarded by Terrence Williams. Edgar Sosa's on the floor now, number 10. Makes a pass defensively, and Tiedemann hits the three.
He can shoot. Stand still. The ability to put it on the bounce and convert.
Sosa out of the New York area. And Character. Jerry Smith. Terrence Williams and Earl Clark.
And Clark's a playmaker in the middle as well. How about this? Now, we had that Georgetown game. He did not shoot well. It changes their style. And here he comes deflecting.
Another turnover. That's 4 for Boise State. Smith kicks it in the corner. Sosa. Reggie Larry with the rebound, and here comes Thomas for Boise State.
Well, you better get back and rebound. They had character at the rim on that jumper.
Trap, Boucher from the corner.
Good rebound.
Larry, good. Oh, wonderful. Nope. Character clears it for Louisville. Williams. Here comes Thomas at the other end, too strong. Oh, he saved it.
You don't want, well, I was going to say, you start a fast break. They have numbers, but Larry hustles back.
And another Louisville turnover. Sosa fires this one, Rick Pitino said. Whoa.
Let's straighten this out.
NCAA March Madness on Demand is streaming every game from the NCAA Championship online for free. You can watch any game anytime at the new NCAA.com.
And you know, watching that timeout with Rick Pitino, he wanted to get everybody's attention because you're giving Boise State an opportunity to get back in with silly passes and an open look to Boucher handling the pressure with his post up. Great Matt, deployment by Greg Graham's guys.
Matt Boucher, who hits 45% from three, had that one just inside the eye. So that's for two. Team 7, Palacios back on the floor now. Jumper, three.
Well, does that help? And nobody was really playing Clark on that particular play.
Now the winner of this one gets the Oklahoma Sooners. Oh dear, boy, oh boy, that's close to a hamstring pull.
And you know what? That happens frequently during the tournament. It's very slippery with the logo.
Right.
You know, on different spots on the floor. If it gets a little bit wet, it's like ice.
Sosa, Palacios, character, Earl Clark, Jerry Smith.
Nice post up. Ooh, character using the bump.
Kurt Cunningham took it away. Cunningham, first man off the bench for Greg Graham's Boise State. Here's Tiedemann for three.
And you got to get up on him. That's what they do. Beautiful. They'll run and push back. And a guy like Tiedemann can really elevate and knock him down.
And so Boise State cuts it to six, a 9-3 run. And Rick Pitino is going to send Terrence Williams back on the floor. Clark.
He's got a game, doesn't he?
Sure does.
He is going to step up next year, I think. Not a good pass here.
Boucher gets it back. Here's Kurt Cunningham out of Sharpsville, Indiana. Jamar Green is on the floor as well. There's a skip pass. Boucher. Jamar Green, the lefty, cans one.
Boy, they can spread you and knock him down. Convert those long passes.
5-point game. Thrown away.
I think of Pitino in that timeout, voicing displeasure because you're giving a team confidence. You're giving them life. You're giving them opportunities to convert at the other end. They're right there now.
Get you back to Birmingham in just a moment after we check in on what's happening elsewhere. In Raleigh, North Carolina, Arkansas and Indiana about ready to come out of a timeout. Indiana started leading this game, but Arkansas has come back to grab a 22-19 lead.
Well, they've knocked down a couple of three-point field goals in transition. Indiana's shot selection has left a bit to be desired. DJ White has two fouls. He'll have to be careful the last 8 minutes. Of this half, Indiana not very deep along that front line.
Yeah, as you can see, neither team really shooting the ball well. John Pelfrey's thrown a zone at Indiana. I think that's frustrated them a little bit. Eric Gordon really likes to drive the ball. There's a lot of his scoring from the foul line. If they sit back in that zone, it's going to force him to make outside shots. I think it's a pretty good strategy.
Meanwhile, in Tampa, Villanova and Clemson are in a timeout. Villanova started cold. They've managed
it to within three. Matt Nelson back on the floor for Boise State. They have gotten right back in the thick of this. They trailed 10-1 and now have gotten back to within three at the 11-minute mark of the first half. Sosa.
That's a plus. You know, he learned how to step into shots as the year progressed.
Started taking,
you can't leave him open.
Tiedemann with the quick three. Nelson couldn't get position for the rebound. Louisville is 5 of 8, Bill, on three-point shots so far.
And, you know, that's the gamble when you pressure. You're going to give guys good opportunities for clean looks.
From the corner, Preston Knowles.
How about Rick? He loves this kid's effort.
Nice pass. In. Matt Nelson's having a tough first half.
Now the pass was actually to the wrong hand, and Carrick got a piece of it.
And that one is on the line. Touch last by Boise State. Greg Graham, sixth season, longtime assistant coach to Ernie Kent at Oregon. Oregon lost earlier tonight to Mississippi State in a first-round game. Here's Carrick.
That's what you want out of him. Put that shoulder in there, square up, and finish. And this kid's fought the weight problem for quite a while. He's not eating M&Ms between games anymore, anyhow.
No.
Just the frame that he possesses and the upside in his game is extraordinary.
Well, we had a chance to spend probably a half an hour with Patino yesterday during the shoot-around. And this Louisville team lost the regular season finale at Georgetown by 3 and then lost in the first round of the Big East in overtime to Pittsburgh. And he said the one mistake he thought he made was not playing character more in that Pittsburgh game.
And in fairness, too, he thought he may have been a little winded. One of the reasons of taking him out, once you take him out, something diverts your attention. You don't get him back in. But I think that's what all coaches do. You know, you question yourself what you could have done to help your team win. The good ones do. I never question myself.
Oh, listen to you. Under 10. Garner's on the floor now. Aaron Garner, a 6'4 junior guard. Screen set by Nelson. Tiedemann.
What a great job. And Carrick gets back just a little bit late. But how about that?
Carrick with the block. Air ball. Fark.
He hit the pipe, I think.
All right.
Not only did he show big, but he recovered. Takes away the little spin move. That is not easy as Matt Nelson tries to drift and get away, but great reaction by the big guy.
Derek Carrick, who has battled not only weight, but discipline problems in his 2 years at Louisville. That one's knocked away. Nice hustle play. Out of bounds, it'll be Louisville ball.
And Nelson got around Carrick, and you've got to hold your guy off. You got to lock him. He's big and strong. That shouldn't happen.
Aaron Garner with a dive for the loose ball, but he touched it last. And Padgett continues to sit with two fouls. Carrick getting extensive playing time. There's a pick and roll. Clark. Oh,
send
well.
It in. Oh,
how about that?
Well, guys from Jersey don't like to show off. A little smooth delivery. He's got a talent.
That's the second time today we've mentioned George Gervin.
Yeah, and appropriately so.
Yeah, the finger roll. Under 9 to go.
And Vern, you mentioned Padgett. He's so meaningful on the offensive end. Nice give. Nelson alert. Larry on the money with the delivery. Nice filling of the hole.
And here come the Cardinals now. They've hit their last 6 in a row. And that basket stopped a 10-0 Louisville run. 28-17, 8.5 to go. First half. Winner here gets Oklahoma. Oklahoma outlasted St. Joe's in the previous game.
Yeah, look at this elbow delivery. This is pretty. They had character on the low block. The fill high by the talented Clark. And uses the bounce.
Earl Clark 3 for 3 in the ball game, and it's a 13-point margin after Boise had fought back, clawed back, really, and gotten within 3. Anthony Thomas, a sophomore out of Mansfield, Texas, not far from the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Nelson.
Played and makes some nice passes, and how about the recovery of Louisville?
Shot missed. Williams with a rebound. Jumper. Nice. Thomas at the other end. It's Larry.
Nice run out. How about that? And securing it without walking and getting control. Gather yourself and then take it to the 10.
Reggie Larry puts it in off the feed from Anthony Thomas, the sophomore. 7:20 to go before halftime. Padgett has been on the bench for most of the first half.
Nice pass. Got to catch it, though.
Character.
Now he's tired right now. He is tired, but not Clark. Fills the hole. The little kiss by the big fella. And then if you don't get back, this team will pick you apart. Larry, with great presence, send it in.
Get 2.9% APR financing on any 2008 midsize H3, plus $1,000 bonus cash toward accessories.
On CBS.
Louisville jumped off to a 10-1 lead. Boise State got back within three, but using the outside shot, the Cardinals have now extended the lead back to 11.
But they've got a nice little thing going with their inside game and outside game, and all without the big fella. And Vern, he went out of the game with 17-01.
Right.
And he's such a catalyst to everything they do. It tells you how this team has improved, because I think a month ago it would be a little chaotic.
Padgett missed the first 10 games of the year with a broken kneecap. Near miraculous that he got back as quickly as he did. Palacios was out for much of the beginning of the season. Now Padgett on the bench with those two fouls. Character, he is on the line and misses the first. Coming up on the AT&T at the half, Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg, Seth Davis take you for a live look at all the action going on in the tournament, and they'll get you caught up on all the latest tournament news, plus an AT&T Coach's Corner. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half.
Now, if you're Boise, you got to be ready for the pressure. You got to look ahead, post, and they'll make you pay if you don't. Also, you got to attack them, I think. Don't give it
Thomas
up.
Thomas has Nelson. Here we go.
Wow. More than a half Nelson at that rim, huh?
Matt Nelson, the senior out of Issaquah, Washington. He, like the other starters, started elsewhere, not at Boise. He was a member of the Eastern Washington team for a couple of years. Here's McGee. 6:35 to go.
Clark didn't see the ball. He went to screen. McGee had picked it up. We got to always get vision on that ball.
Clark for three. Oh. They have been almost perfect from beyond the arc.
If he makes that, he's only at 21%. He is the total package, 7 of 10 from 3. Ooh.
And Clark, 4 for 4 from the field. 13-point margin. Thomas, Jamar Green, here's Boucher.
Nice look.
Underneath, great feed.
And Boucher, great confidence. That gets in the lane. And you look like you have something, and Louisville closes it up quickly.
.545 remaining. That will be Boise State ball, the Broncos.
That's one of those you don't need. You got to play within the system there. Can always get that one later in the shot clock.
Now Palacios will replace Character. And for Boise State, Greg Graham's team, Mark Sanchez is on for the first time, number 43. Here's Thomas across the midcourt line. Back to McGee. Boucher, they've got the green light, don't they?
They sure do. They shoot it confidently.
Wow.
And it's tippable. They're so soft with their delivery, you can get offensive rebounds.
Boucher misses on that three. Here's Clark. Smith.
Yeah, he's got the license, too. And Pitino doesn't get mad when you play the other end. You can take the shot if that's your capability. Well, he was after them tonight, didn't he?
You didn't have to lip read. You could hear Rick pass the ball.
He's preached on selfish play since the beginning of his coaching tenure. His extraordinary coaching tenure, I might add.
Well, the only coach to ever get three college teams into the Final Four. Did so Providence, Kentucky, and, of course, Louisville a couple years ago. And here's another foul on Boise State.
Yeah, the late close.
And that's going to send Juan Palacios to the line. Memorable moment for him. His mom made the trip from his hometown in Medellin, Colombia, and got to see him play in Louisville for the first time ever. Getting a scholarship with zero skills, about as unbelievable as getting real Coke taste and zero calories. Win a $25,000 scholarship from Coke Zero at MyCokeRewards.com.
You know, and I might add that his mom wore his glasses, the goggles. They had a goggle day.
That's right.
And she was in the stands with them. Very fitting. I usually don mine when I'm deep sea diving, you know.
Trying to find your way home.
Oh, look at this aggressive play and the coverage. They get back in form. Need to get a five.
Yep. Sanchez. Yeah, he didn't want that shot.
Well, you just can't simulate the speed in your practice that Louisville exhibits. And Greg Graham getting in the right spots, just closing the gap quickly.
Two on the shot clock. Shot clock violation.
Now that's Louisville basketball. You can see Rick Pitino applauding. The fans responding. They win it on that end. And today they're shooting it. And when they shoot it, they are an awfully tough out.
Well, over the course of the season, no surprise here, they have given up only 38% from the field. Sixth best in Division I. And there's Palacios chasing down the long rebound. 35-23 with 4:02 to go. Williams.
Tough shot. You got to use the glass if you're going to do that kind of a shot. Better off, better serve not taking it.
Anthony Thomas, the sophomore. Reggie Larry.
And I think Williams, he got back late and ended up fouling.
3:45 to go, first half.
Gentlemen, to really embrace the three-point shot when it came in was Rick Pitino.
Right.
And it has prospered under his tutelage at Louisville. They're making them, and it's such a different team. They're spreading it out. I mentioned Clark even able to convert from outside. Early in the year, if Jerry Smith didn't make any, they really didn't have a go-to guy. So now, look at this unbelievable percentage after going around 33, 34% for the year.
And over the course of the year, they have made 7.5 per game. They've got seven through the hoop already. Here's Reggie Larry missing the first free throw. Reggie Larry, young man out of New Jersey, came west, spent 2 years at the College of Southern Idaho in Twin Falls, and then found himself at Boise State on schedule to graduate. He will be the first in his family to accomplish that.
Isn't that a great story? Ballinger High in Newark, New Jersey, by the cathedral there, Sacred Heart Cathedral.
Palacios.
How about this?
You got to be kidding.
This is a clinic. Just picking them apart, zone or man. And a turnover here, thrown behind. And that's just a shame as Tito was going one way, and the ball came the other.
Largest lead of the ball game now is 14 with 3:21 to go. Now Palacios, another like Earl Clark, you don't expect anything like that. That's only the 13th three he's made all year.
Yeah, he's at 27%, so he's not a guy that you're going to go to frequently. Look at character get to the box and just impose his masculinity emphatically.
And Jerry Smith gets the ball from Andre McGee. What hustle by McGee. And what acknowledgement by the Louisville fans.
Boy, he got this team ready this week. I think you're right about the, there's an offensive foul.
You know, he yesterday said, no, I really was not concerned with the two losses.
Come on.
You don't think? No, of course not.
He gives you that dialogue, that New York fast step, and you fell for it.
40-24 Louisville. They've been tearing it up from the three-point range. And at one point, Boise got from nine down to within three. And then Louisville has just extended itself from beyond the arc. Here's Tiedemann. Yeah.
They can get back in it because they make threes and they play with confidence. They only gave him two on that.
Inside the line. So it's 40-26 with 2:23 to go before the halftime break.
The big thing for Louisville is keeping their concentration. Once in a while, it'll lapse, try a little fast action passing.
They have been just terrific from outside. Here's McGee. David Padgett has been on the bench with two fouls. He went there 3 minutes into the game.
Nice hands.
Oh, a trip. Oh. No call.
Got to give it to him. That's a shame. That really is. They come right back at him, though.
Bauscher, Reggie Larry, no. Williams with the rebound. From the corner, Palacios puts it on the floor, kicks it outside, no.
Oh, Character's hurt.
Character's down, might have got inadvertently kicked in the face. Matt Nelson, exasperated, looking at the official. He was the one who got tripped a moment ago.
A lot of guys holding their shorts out there. This is a fast-paced Louisville-style uptick offense. And you can see right here, once you reach in, he bangs heads with his own teammate. That is really tough. Just watch this. What a headache.
Oh, boy.
Boy, he stayed alert, too. He can take a hit. A little groggy going off, though.
Understandably.
It's about the only thing they did wrong, huh? They didn't avoid one another.
1:27 to go before the break. 42-26. Louisville and Boise State. And here's the ball underneath.
Nice ball. Nice use of the screen off of Larry. That flex cut. And then the presence to have patience.
Tyler Tiedemann with that basket. Oklahoma outlasted St. Joseph's in the game played previous to this one. St. Joe's came back to within four late in the ball game before falling. And this one thrown away again. Well, we've seen a little bit of sloppy basketball from Louisville. That's nine turnovers already.
And that's one once in a while they just don't keep in mind or focus as to, is it there? Can I make the play? You got to let your teammate down once in a while by saying, look, you're overplayed. I can't get it to you. They've got to understand.
Matt Bauscher gives it off to Thomas, the only sophomore in the starting lineup. This is Nelson in the corner. Another three. Tyler Tiedemann. He's hitting 49% from three-point range for the year. Bill mentioned earlier, started his career as a baseball pitcher at Arizona. Suffered the Tommy John disease, injury,
right,
and elected not to have the surgery. Transferred to Boise State and has become a real important part of this Boise State basketball team.
Well, he gets real wide, and Nelson with a great look. And now they got to think about a rebound and don't give a second opportunity to Louisville.
Sosa, 2 seconds to go. And Clark will go to the free throw line.
Oof, was that aggressive? And Tiedemann not backing off either. Talk about the ability to pass the ball. Sosa with a great look here. Williams we always think about, but Sosa has matured, I think, in making much better decisions than Clark taking it aggressively.
Rick Pitino was chatting earlier this year about getting his team to buy into it. And he said the first one who bought into it, who kind of was on the periphery, was Earl Clark.
Mm-hmm.
Then he said Derek Character bought into it. And he thought he was making real progress when Edgar Sosa bought into it.
Well, you know, when you say buy in, playing with one another.
Absolutely.
Within the framework, being ready, obeying.
A little less individualism.
Right.
It's halftime. Louisville shoots 57% from the field in the first half. We're going to send you to Greg Gumbel with AT&T at the half after this message and this word from your local station.
Men's Basketball Championship is sponsored by Bud Light, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, Jordan, and by Pontiac.
we get set for the start of the second half, Louisville up by 13. Here is the in-game box score powered by CBS College Sports Network, the 24-hour college sports channel from CBS Sports. Halftime in Birmingham, Vern Lundquist along with Bill Raftery. We get set to watch this Louisville-Boise State game. I think that was as good as Louisville can play offensively.
Yeah, talking to some of their people, Kenny Pine, the SID, said that's the best offense they've had. Can they continue it? Has Boise weathered the storm now? Can they rely on their defense and their ability to score? So I think Louisville's got to be consistent and focused. And once in a while, they'll lose focus and throw some errant passes.
And, Bill, they played all but 3 minutes without their center, David Padgett.
Unbelievable. I mean, the extraordinary effort that they put forth without him. He's the catalyst. He's the point center that makes great decisions. And yet their ability to shoot, Clark and character, coming up big time for the Cardinals.
Terrence Williams will inbound. Padgett's on the floor. Palacios, McGee, and Smith. And for Boise State, it's Boucher, Larry, Nelson, Tiedemann, and Thomas. So starting fives for both squads. Winner gets Oklahoma on Sunday.
Nice back screen, and they get Padgett down on the block.
Now Nelson comes out to try and front it. Right side. Now left.
Padgett loves to screen and slip. Look at that diagonal look.
Williams, two on the shot clock, fade away.
Pretty
not there,
trip.
Palacios offensive board.
That's a pretty good trip, though. Got a great shot, the follow.
Nelson, or Tiedemann rather, back outside. Boucher has it.
Always got a hand in there, don't they? This is the zone. They've been mixing it up. Makes and misses.
Tiedemann. Boucher tries to fire, and Padgett gets in the lane. Palacios.
It continues, huh? That's more his range, though. A great steal by Padgett to set it up.
They have just been torrid offensively. Boucher, Palacios out to grab him defensively in the corner. Entry pass, Tiedemann, Reggie, Larry up and off the glass with a reverse.
He is clever for his size. Nice run out by Padgett. What's he going to do with it? Not much.
Couldn't.
No.
So far underneath the basket.
You don't need it, particularly when you're holding the hammer.
Thomas, Boucher for three, off the mark. Padgett, no. Thomas with the rebound. Up and under by Padgett, got it.
Well, this team hangs tough, and Rick Pitino not real happy. He's looking for a sub. Got to concentrate.
Oh, hi, I'm Jackie Moon.
On this Friday, take a look at line two. Western Kentucky Drake, best game of the tournament thus far in Tampa. Both 13 seeds advanced. How about some stars? Well, Stephen Curry, Dell's son, lit it up for 40 points. Jack McClinton, 38 points. Deshaun Jackson hit the game winner against UConn. And Ty Rogers hit the game winner for Western Kentucky against Drake.
Way to step up, huh? What bigger or better stage? Clark really not played as he slipped to the rim. Good counter.
Here's Anthony Thomas, number 11. Takes it all the way into the trees and then leaves it on the floor. Boucher, Tiedemann.
Well, he should have shot it.
Now he's in trouble.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. You pass it up. Boucher just giving it up, really.
That's an oofta. Matt Boucher mentioned there are three graduates starting for this Boise State team. He's one of them. Boucher out of Caldwell, Idaho. Major in poli science.
Yeah, Nelson
political
business,
science.
Right?
Yeah.
Tiedemann Communications. They're down all after a second degree. Pretty impressive.
And Larry will graduate in December. Here's Smith. Padgett.
Doesn't make mistakes. Seldom.
What a fine senior year he's had.
Oh, it's just magnificent. almost gets a foul trying to get to the offensive glass, but he kicked it out, and they are playing as well as we've seen them, Vern.
I've seen them four times this year, and this is nothing like this. This is really extraordinary. Now Padgett's back defensively. Back outside to Thomas. That one out of bounds, and it will be Boise State ball.
They always look like they've got six or seven guys on the floor, don't they? Hands in the way, bodies yes. in the way.
Well, it's defense that propels it, but then look at what they've done offensively.
That's what changes their whole outlook as a team.
Boucher. Reggie Larry. Boise State out of the Western Athletic Conference. Carl Benson, the commissioner, is here.
And once again, the hands got to make a decision here.
Nelson, no roll. Saved by Clark. Here's Terrence Williams for the Cardinals. Smith looks inside for Clark, settles for Padgett.
They do a nice job with their high-low.
There's the screen, which leaves McGee open. Oh. And he's not much of an offensive threat normally.
How about that, though? Just draw it up. He's at 41% from three, but you're right. He's more of the defensive guy.
The Louisville Cardinals are 10 of 17 from three-point range.
Remember how you felt about Carr as a kid? We do. Introducing the first ever Pontiac GHET, the most powerful car under 30 grand.
We represent the Coke brand. We would like to sue Coca-Cola Zero for taste infringement.
I'm an immigration lawyer.
We feel that your expertise might be able to be a way to think outside the box.
I think, personally, not that speaking outside the box, and I hate that kind of language. I deal with families and things, and I appreciate what you're trying to do.
And
now that I think of it, Ron, mm-hmm. the head of the Coke Zero team's Canadian. Could we have him deported?
Da, 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 da.
Hey, bud.
Hey, buddy.
How's it going?
What's up?
We're shaking.
Popping. Cracking.
Yeah, buddy.
Brother.
Dude.
What's up?
What's up?
Hey.
Bro.
Hey.
Daddy.
Darling.
Sweetie.
Buddy.
Beautiful.
Aww.
Buddy.
Now it's easier than ever to stay in touch from your AT&T wireless phone. Introducing unlimited calling to anyone in the U.S. on the network with the best wireless coverage. AT&T. Your world delivered. And now get an exclusive smartphone for $99.99.
Chuck. Chuck. Chuck.
Chuck. Laughter can add 8 years to your life. So live longer, retire stronger, never outlive your money. Ask your financial advisor about AIG.
Guitar Hero 3, Legends of Rock. Rated T for Teen.
15:57 to go in regulation. The best place to get college sports today is College Sports Tonight. Get inside the latest news, scores, highlights, and more only on the CBS College Sports Network, the new pulse of college sports. Louisville dominating. Boise State playing tough, but they just can't climb back in.
The tough defense is part of it, but also the ability of Louisville to get some runouts and also make it some deep shots, shooting beautifully. There they go, a little climb back in.
Anthony Thomas gets the basket. That cuts it to 16. Clark can't hang on to it. Nelson gets it. Matt Nelson, the senior.
Now, Thomas has a lot of responsibility. Run the team, bite you once in a while with that jumper.
Reggie Larry fires it. They get inside. No, taken away by Jerry Smith.
And how about this approach? I mean, they've really been right on top of their game. Not forcing the issue.
15 Boise State turnovers.
Nice fade dribble. What a catch here by
Padgett. Oh, it was. Wow. Padgett kicks it outside. McGee puts it on the floor. And then Terrence Williams has it in his hands.
Now, I'd say they bought in, huh? Clark over the top, but should have made the first one. Wouldn't have happened.
Well, as you can imagine, this is a predominantly Louisville Cardinal crowd. It's a little closer from Louisville than it is from Boise to Birmingham. And so not that many purchased tickets to get down here.
You're a topographer, huh? You really know your...
Hey, I'm a West Coast guy.
I mean, you know you...
Boise. Steamboat Springs is not that far from Boise,
that's
let me tell
true.
You.
And you mentioned they chartered down here. They have some
they
tough
did.
Trips, don't they, this team?
That one's off the mark there. Ah, goaltending. Yeah, the Western Athletic Conference is spread all the way from Hawaii to Louisiana Tech in Ruston, Louisiana, and those aren't charter flights.
No, they're long trips, right? A lot of stops.
Yeah. 54-40, 14:25 to go.
They've run that elbow offense very well. One high, one low.
Clark, Smith. Inside, Clark again.
Boy, that's just a great flash and fine. Flawless. And a little bump by Smith.
Nelson, reverse.
Nelson.
They keep coming, though, don't they, Boise?
Indeed.
This is a good basketball team.
Sosa's on the floor. Here's Padgett.
They gave it to him. That's what he does. He takes what you give him.
They do have some options. Preston Knowles getting ready to come back on now for Rick Pitino's team. Here's Boucher, Thomas.
Nice cross. What?
Guess who? Smith, 2-on-1. Williams will take it. Boucher back. Boucher with the foul. Wave after wave after wave.
Everybody comes in, does a terrific job.
Williams shoots one. And then another. All right, Bill, referee. Tonight on The Late Show, don't you dare miss Sean Diddy Combs. And then Monday, Dave's All New with Demi Moore, Demi Moore, and Counting Crows, also on CBS.
Well, if you show me the Benjamins, our crack crew coming up with some of the great songs.
Yeah, well, if you can do the lyrics right now.
Next week.
Next week?
Hopefully he'll be appearing again.
Well, by then, he may have changed his name again. 13:15 to go.
Louisville's not changing their game the way they're playing, huh?
Noonan's on. Paul Noonan for the first time tonight. Noonan and Cunningham off the Boise bench.
Now, this switch man to zone has really thrown him off. Tiedemann uses that bump by Cunningham to get to the box.
Preston Knowles, his first. Greg Graham, sixth year head coach, Boise State. Mentioned he grew up 5 miles from the Pro Football Hall of Fame in Louisville, Ohio. Here's Cunningham. Jumper, no. Derek Character's back on the floor, giving Padgett a blow, and Character with a rebound. Right side, Sosa gives it up. Knowles. Here's Character.
Nice drop step. How about that, huh? Is he at home down on the block? The kid is growing up.
Yeah, Preston Knowles with a cheap little reach-in foul.
This is a lot of work. I mean, he's got big body to know where your defender is, control him with your dirty air, and then drop to the middle and a deft left touch as well.
K Character with 9 points, perfect from the line. Boise State will inbound. Clark replaced by Palacios for the Cardinals.
Look at the quickness, and they got to walk first. Yep. All because of the harassing in the backcourt and Palacios being alert for him.
61-42 with 12:31 to go. And the official is telling the Louisville bench, sit down, fellas. And so they do.
It's the only thing they've done wrong.
Looked like they were getting ready to pass the plate for the offering. They all sat down at once.
Well, it's that time of year.
It is. If we get an all rise, we'll know something different's going on. Sosa.
Oh, tough luck. Knowles, Rick Pitino's funny. He jumped up. Bites his tongue a little bit. If they play defense, it's okay with him. He'll live with some mistakes.
12 minutes to go. First round game from Birmingham, Alabama. First time Boise State has been in the tournament since 1994. Tough mountain to climb here to get back in this thing.
Character once again showing, but didn't stop the shot. Get everything recovered, and I think he might be coming out because of that.
Yes, Padgett's going to come back on the floor.
Nice pump.
Williams adjusts to the air. Cunningham with a rebound for the Broncos. And Terrence Williams was down, is late getting back down the floor. Thomas.
Run out.
Here is Palacios.
Nice and easy. Once again, the long rebound, they're able to turn it into a deuce at the other end.
Noonan back outside. We near the 11-minute mark. And again, this predominantly Louisville Cardinal crowd standing and applauding. Juan Palacios is perfect. 5 for 5. Louisville near so.
Rubber ball, $6. Softball, $5. Football, $35. Being ready for whatever parenthood throws at you, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's credit or debit MasterCard.
Your car has never been more real. Introducing the first ever Pontiac G8 GT, the most powerful car under 30 grand.
Louisville Cardinals are cruising, and they are cruising at a high altitude because of 10 of 18 from three-point range. They've also gotten 28 points off the bench. Earl Clark leading the Cardinals with 13 points, and they're up by 19.
Not very much has gone wrong for Louisville. They've just been on top of their game.
Matt Nelson with the tip for the Broncos, and we near the midway point of the second half. Preston Knowles to Palacios. David Padgett back on the floor. Earl Clark getting ready to come back. Here's Terrence Williams. Knowles, the freshman, number two. Sosa, the sophomore. And the foul is going to be called on Anthony Thomas.
And when they clear out that side so you can take advantage of your guy if you so decide. And Sosa showing a little bit of strength going right at the numbers.
Edgar Sosa, the sophomore, started much of last year, has come off the bench for most of this year, where he's averaging 8 points per game. Clark on, Palacios out. 10:33 to go. Louisville comes in with a 24-8 record. We mentioned they got that really rough start because Padgett and Palacios. It's never a good thing when the two guys in the cover of your media guide are not available to play for the first third of the year.
Yeah, they had a herky-jerky year because of that at the beginning. And then they got them all back and smooth running. And when they make plays offensively, this is some team. Nice little pry by offensive maneuver by Noonan.
Winner of this one will get Oklahoma here on Sunday in the second round game. The Oklahoma Sooners out of the Big 12, the sixth seed, outlasted St. Joseph's in the previous game here. Here's Sosa.
Nice.
Oh, beautiful.
How about that?
No look pass to Padgett and a free throw coming.
So much for bad knees, huh?
How about Sosa, the pass from Sosa?
What a great look. And he just walks away. Rick Pitino's trying to get his attention to compliment him. You might as well take it. Get over there, Edgar.
You bet. Absolutely.
You know, you've had a few on your chest.
Now watch this. This is going to be.
I love the way he slips. He just slips. He finally takes the applause.
And Sosa walked over. Rick Pitino gave him a little pat on the chest. Under 10 to go.
That could change quickly.
I know.
You know how coaches are.
Could be a finger pointed at him soon.
What can you do for me lately? That sounds familiar to both of us.
66-48, 9:42 to go. Here's Noonan.
Pretty.
Sure was. Reggie Larry with the dunk.
I like this team a lot, too. Bauscher with the nice penetration and fine. Now they keep playing, and Greg Graham's done a great job with them.
Williams goes left side to Sosa. Jamar Green getting ready to come back on the floor. Tiedemann as well. Outside, Terrence Williams, three. Rebound, Thomas. Left corner, Noonan. No, Clark. Nice.
He can gather, can he? This kid can rebound with the best of them. He had a game. And he's more like a perimeter player.
Mm-hmm. Thomas for the steal, and it's knocked out of bounds. So at the dead ball now, Jerry Smith and Andre McGee back on for Preston Knowles. And Jamar Green and Tiedemann back in the floor for Boise State.
Does Boise win that WAC title you mentioned, being Hawaii, Utah State, New Mexico State?
And again, they were coached by a former Rick Pitino assistant.
And that really, in terms of preparation, you have an idea, but this is a different level. This speed and organization, the response has been exceptional.
Clark calls for it. One on the shot clock. Padgett, no. Shot clock violation.
Now, see, that would upset Rick Pitino because you've got to be alert. That's part of his mantra. Knowing the game.
Full court pressure applied now by Louisville on the turnover. Tiedemann saves it.
Pretty good catch.
Bauscher, Larry, clean block. Terrence Williams out of bounds on Williams.
But they are so alert, so attuned to what's going on.
Mentioned they got the rough start, Rick Pitino's team. We saw them lose at Purdue. They lost back-to-back games, Dayton and Purdue. But then, as they often do, February was a a wonderful ride. They were 8-0. They won their ninth straight game before getting knocked off, and then, as we said, losing the last two, the game at Georgetown and then the Pittsburgh loss.
The Purdue game, you remember how poorly they shot the ball?
Oh.
I mean, they couldn't make one. And that's the difference in this team.
That was back in December, the John Wooden tradition at Kinseco in Indianapolis.
A nice challenge by Williams.
Williams loose at the other end. They didn't see him or elected not to throw it to him. 8 minutes to go, first round game, Louisville and Boise State.
Now they like to X off the high post and pin down and lock low. And here's the lock low.
Back outside for three. Tiedemann gets the rebound for the Broncos. Nelson hurries down. Jamar Green. Here's Larry.
He can make the shot. Pagin knows it. Stays up on him.
Tough battle. Nelson.
Everything's a fight, though. Nothing goes easily against Louisville.
Nelson with 14 points, 7:13 to go in the ball game. Boise's climbed back within 14 points. Clark. Boucher with the rebound for Boise State. Tiedemann with the lead for Jamar Green. We're under 7 remaining. Largest lead of the night was 19 points.
Tell you, Deuster right there, and they get the foul on Pagin, unable to defend with the third foul.
Time call.
Welcome to the Sign Then Drive event.
Ta-da! What do you think?
I love it.
Yeah, it's really good.
What's happening?
If you want, I could put a sold sign on the car.
No, this works just fine.
The Sign Then Drive event is back. No down payment, no first month's payment, zero due at signing.
Fidelity is helping more people retire than any other company. So if you left a 401k at an old job, bring it to Fidelity. We make it easy for you. We even help with the paperwork. We'll help you choose your investments for free. Put your retirement savings back to work. Roll over to a Fidelity IRA. Stop in or call 1-800-FIDELITY.
So I told him, I want it delivered free, I want it delivered the next day, I want it hooked up free, and I want you to take away the old one free or there's no deal. Oh yeah, they made the deal.
Nice work, Dad.
At Lowe's, we offer free next-day delivery and haul-away. Lowe's, let's build something together.
Use your Lowe's consumer card and pay nothing for 12 months on any purchase of $299 or more.
Tuesday on DVD from the legendary tale by Stephen King.
Something in the mist!
When there is no warning.
Holy!
There will be no escape.
Kill it!
The Mist, rented exclusively at Blockbuster or on the 2-disc special edition Tuesday.
They pick up touchdowns, pick up the bucks, and pick up their teams. Enterprise salutes NCAA student athletes for picking us all up. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
When the flu hits, Charlie's got his own cure.
Nighttime cold medicine and scotch. I call it the Drunken Hulk.
A new 2.5 Men, CBS Monday.
Tiger has taken his game to a new stratosphere. Now he begins his quest for the perfect season. A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS.
I think we got some graduate students in the Louisville band.
I think you're right.
There's some guys with AARP cards in there.
A few PGers.
Yeah. 14-point Louisville lead. Working on his doctorate?
Well, they said they were going to keep him in the band till he got it right. He keeps on plugging. Or two.
Matt Nelson at the line. 6:40 to go in this ball game. Boise State with a 25-8 record coming in. Earned the right to be here by virtue of a triple overtime win at New Mexico State. Sunday on CBS, Dexter investigates his own crime scene on an all-new episode. That's Sunday at 10, 9 Central on CBS.
And take a look at that scoreboard all of a sudden. You know, within hailing distance.
Yeah, sure.
The way they can shoot it.
Earl Clark tips it to Padgett. A 13-point. The largest lead of the game was 19. Williams. Clark wants it, gets it. Two more.
Getting Clark. Whatever they want. Here's a turnover on the inbounds.
McGee with a steal. Jamar Green gets the miss. And now Matt Bauscher comes across, takes the three.
Yeah, they had numbers there, too.
Too quick with the three?
Well, I thought he had Tiedemann initially, but then he was forced to take it himself.
Nelson on Padgett, bring it back outside. Under six remaining.
But Padgett is the boss when he's out there. Just hear him clap his hands, get me the ball. Great decision maker. Why not? Take one once in a while, big fella. The little jump hook. Nobody came to double Vern. Too many bounces. Somebody's got to come down here and just stick a hand in there. But that's what happens when you've got three-point shooters like Smith on that wing.
Right.
You're afraid. You go down to Coach Hollers that you for giving up the three.
Padgett limited to 3 minutes because of his two fouls in the first half. So his most significant contribution, obviously, here in the second half. Missed the free throw. 5:40 to go.
Dr. Norman Scott, who operated on him, said it's amazing he was able to play. Longtime friend of Rick Pitino's, former New York Knicks doctor. Just said this kid went through so much to get himself ready. He's amazed.
5:23 to go. Foul on Smith. Anthony Thomas getting ready to reappear now for Boise State. And Larry's going to go to the line. We were talking about the distance between some of the WAC cities. Here's Larry with a free throw. Just to give you, well, he missed it.
Nice communication. Unfortunately,
Thomas
are very alert.
Outside, entry pass.
No,
Clark,
They got what they wanted to, Vern, sorry.
They had a timeout called by one of the officials.
Now they need some.
Well, we were talking as they clean up the ice. Here's a road trip for Boise State, back-to-back games. And look at this. Here's how you get to Louisiana Tech. Fly from Boise through Denver, DFW to Shreveport. 1 hour bus ride to Louisiana Tech. You win. The next day, Ruston to Shreveport on the bus. Fly from Shreveport, DFW, El Paso. Take a bus to Las Cruces. Lose to New Mexico State. After a 1 hour bus ride, fly to El Paso, through Phoenix, and back home. And then go to class.
You think you love the game? Greg's saying they throw movies on once in a while.
It ain't all first class.
No. You're working your way.
Absolutely. And they earned the right to fly the charter down here from Boise to Birmingham. Here's Padgett in the corner.
Trying to get the ref to buy in. And nice look again by Padgett. But you know, when you love the game, that stuff doesn't bother you.
That's right.
Plus, you've got buddies, you've got conversations, lifelong friendships you're developing. But, oh, lose the game and be the coach. You know, you want to be under the bus.
4:45 to go. That foul is on Thomas. Now, these two schools have pretty decent football programs, too, right?
Yeah, the famous field where Craig was talking about, everybody recognizes.
And they played in a memorable bowl game a couple of years ago, won by Louisville, 44-40. And then, of course, last year, an even more famous game as Boise State knocked off Oklahoma, had a chance, had they won this game, to meet Oklahoma in basketball on Sunday. It does not appear that's going to happen. But Terrence Williams heads to the bench. His work through for the night.
What would you call that famous play, the Boise State man?
Oh, man.
I mean, odd Statue of Liberty kind of a thing. Was there a name for it?
I don't know.
Okay.
Hook and lateral? No, not really. Chris Peterson, the football coach, would tell you.
It was amazing. Well, they have a name for it, I'm sure.
Yeah. It was one of the great college football games ever. It's an oofta.
Oh, Patchen almost got hurt on that side. Look at this
kid's
effort.
How about the blind drive, the blind pass?
He just never stops. He's relentless. He came in and got the foul. They really didn't need it. Give them that basket.
4:31 to go. Padgett.
Now Padgett knows he made a mistake. He said very seldom does he, but look at this effort. Now he's out of the play, trips, and now look how quickly. This is just effort. I know Rick Pitino wasn't happy about it whatsoever. No need when you've got a commanding lead to do that, but that's the way he plays, number four on him.
And so he is on the bench. So is Earl Clark, and so is McGee. And at the line, Reggie Larry. Nope. So on the floor for Louisville now, Smith, Sosa has the ball. Character, Williams and Palacios.
Now you can just see the defense not there. Then Bauscher never got over the top of that little screen.
Earlier this year, Louisville hit 22 threes in a win against Hartford. They're not close to that, but it seems like they are.
Well, you know, the level of play, 11 of 23, is just amazing. And how about Boise coming right back at you, though?
Yeah.
Unabashed by a terrific performance offensively by Louisville. The combination is lethal when you think of it. They put both ends together.
Matt Nelson at the line. Shooting two. Louisville with 10 team fouls, so Boise in the double bonus for the rest of the way. You know, this has absolutely nothing to do, but Tyler Tiedemann is out here in the midcourt. Now, these kids have earned the right to be in the NCAA tournament. And as he walked over, I just saw him look up into the fan base of Boise State. It's Tiedemann, number 20. And he caught the eye of a family member, and he just smiled.
Isn't that great?
It was neat. You know, enjoy the moment, a memory, you're here. And that was terrific.
And they worked so hard to get here. It's sort of a lonely, but the last couple of minutes are going to be tough on anybody who loses in the tournament. We know that.
Into the corner, Williams, terrific player. Palacios, Sosa.
Smart. Use the clock, make the extra pass. By the way, Nelson is great at running rim to rim. That's when he got fouled on the last trip. They don't lack for effort, this team. Look, good split. I don't know. See, that's where he gets a little haywire.
Yeah, Pitino's claiming it was tipped by the Broncos. Not the case. 3 minutes and 48 seconds to go. Louisville Cardinals 75, Boise State 57. Let's go to Greg in New York.
All right, Vern.
In the second, 18-18.
3:45 remaining here, Greg. 75-57. Louisville on the verge of advancing to take on Oklahoma on Sunday in the second round game in Birmingham. Boise State with a drive in the basket.
Nice job using that high screen. Noonan with hesitation. And then the blow by.
3:22 to go. Smith, Williams, Character, Sosa, and Palacios.
Nice help by Tiedemann.
That was off Character, so it'll be Boise State ball. Padgett back on now, playing with four fouls. And Earl Clark's going to come back on the floor for Louisville as well. He'll replace Palacios. 3:11 to go, 75-59.
Nice play, isn't that?
Sure was.
Larry with a nice catchable bounce pass. And getting himself in good position. Then Nelson with the dive. You can see why they were successful. Solid around the perimeter. Smart kids.
Nelson with 17 points and 3 of 4 from the free throw line. Tonight, Chevrolet players of the game, Tyler Tiedemann, 12 points on 5 of 9 shooting for the Boise State Broncos. Earl Clark, 6 of 8 from the field and 15 points total. They are tonight's Chevrolet players of the game.
Now, Chris Nelson on that foul line, newcomer of the year last year to WAC, third in the USA in field goal percentage, even though he does struggle from the free throw line at 63.
Sosa brings it across. We're under 3 to go in this first round game. First meeting in 14 years in the NCAA between these two. And Boise State is going to run their mark to 0-5 in NCAA appearances. For the Cardinals, of course, veterans, 34th NCAA tournament. Twice they were national champions. They won it under Denny Crum in 1980 and 1986. Here's Smith. Got it.
86, of course, was never nervous.
Never nervous, Purvis.
And of course, we always tease Jay Billis, our colleague, about holding him to 38 or whatever it was. And then we always say that Jay fouled out.
Yeah, that's right. Louisville beat Duke that game in Dallas. Here's Thomas.
Nice
good block by Sosa, and the basket is good. Reggie Larry. Louisville, 50% on threes tonight, 12 of 24.
Now, Greg Graham's guys get 82 points a game. It has been a struggle to get to 60.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, yet again, Louisville's defense fuels their offense, but they were exemplary offensively tonight.
Now, Tiedemann's playing right to the end. He's right. He slapped the ball off of Williams. He's smiling. That's not a family member.
Yeah, that's right.
Unless they're related.
Here's Sosa, Padgett. 1:40 to go. It'll be Louisville. There's the foul on Tiedemann. Terrence Williams. So on Sunday, Oklahoma and Louisville. It's a 6 seed against a 3. By the way, they played 3 times previously, and Louisville has yet to defeat Oklahoma. They are 0-3 in basketball. Butler takes on Tennessee. That will be an intriguing second round game. Everybody who watched Butler win today has to go away impressed with the quality of their team play.
Precision, Mark, isn't it?
And so the path is going to come to a close for these seniors on the Boise State team, among whom is Nelson, who just missed that shot, Tiedemann, Boucher, Reggie Larry, Thomas, the only starter back. And the Louisville faithful standing to salute the Louisville Cardinals, who advance to the second round again. And as soon as this game is official, we'll send it to Clemson and Villanova, who are having a heck of a tussle tied now midway through the second half.
And you know, I love the way Louisville has played with dignity, just done their job, none of the nonsense. just great. Respecting the opponent.
Now 45 seconds to go. ...15 on the shot clock. Congratulations to the Boise State Broncos, their first appearance since 94, and to the Louisville Cardinals. If you want to pick a three seed that might go a long, long way in this tournament, you could do worse than to choose them.
Well, the way they guard, and definitely when they shoot it like this, they're unselfish. They've always been that way, and guys getting an opportunity of a lifetime now. Coming into the game.
Will Scott is going to come on. You mentioned his dad, Dr. Norman Scott. And Terrence Farley, a senior whose minutes have been reduced this year, he's going to be on for the final 23 seconds. Padgett heads to the bench. Stuart Miller also going to get on the floor, wearing number 0 for Louisville. And for the game, 56% from three-point range.
Wow. Wow.
Or for the game, 50% from three.
Boggles your mind. Yep. And a nice touch by both coaches.
Boise State has cleared the bench as well. Final 20 seconds. It's Louisville, Oklahoma in one game on Sunday. It'll be Butler in Tennessee in the other. Here's Green. Garner off the mark. Track down, so Louisville wins it 79-61. Unless this falls, we're going to go to Greg Gumbel in New York.
All right, Vern, thank you very much. So Louisville, a 79-61 winner. The Cardinals move on to face Oklahoma on Sunday. Meanwhile, in Tampa, Villanova and Clemson. 3-point lead for the Villanova Wildcats. 8:41 to play. Tim Brando.